Anita is here in our medical confessional, and Anita, tell us what's going on with your body.
I'm 60 years old, and I've been told by a clinic that I have a prolapsed uterus. This is an organ that's literally hanging between my legs. It's the size of a large pear, which peels. The peeling causes bleeding, and the size of it makes it hard for me to urinate and also walk. Doctors, what can I do?
How long have you been dealing with this?
10 years now.
Wow. And you're married, correct?
Yes, I am.
Have you discussed this issue with your husband? How has it impacted your relationship with him?
It's so embarrassing. We have not been intimate for all this time.
Wow. So first and foremost, I do want to thank you for sharing your story and asking this question. Yeah. Thank you. And I also want you to know that you are not alone, because what you're describing sounds like pelvic organ prolapse, and it impacts over 3 million women in the United States alone. So let's talk about what pelvic organ prolapse is. So let's take a look at this demo. So here we see that you have your vagina, and this is your bladder, this is your rectum, and this is your uterus. So any of these organs can prolapse. In the case of uterine prolapse, the uterus actually slides down the vaginal canal, and you can get prolapse that way. Or if you have a hysterectomy, so you don't have a uterus, you can lose support at the top of your vagina, and you can get what's called vaginal vault prolapse. So any of those organs can prolapse. So now that we know what prolapse is, we talk about the things that could potentially cause it. So vaginal deliveries, childbirth, or if you have chronic constipation, if you're coughing a lot of heavy lifting, or sometimes just the aging process itself. So if someone has prolapse, the thing is the severity can vary. Sometimes people have a small bulge and they don't notice any symptoms at all. However, sometimes people will have prolapse that's so severe, if this is the vaginal canal and we're talking about uterine prolapse, the uterus can actually be seen coming out of the vaginal opening. So as you can tell, that can be pretty severe for a person, and it can really impact their daily life. And overall, people can have symptoms like problems with urination, problems with defecation, pain with sex, or they may feel pressure or pain in the pelvic area.
Anita's granddaughter, Annika, actually wrote into the show on her behalf, which I'm really glad you did. Tell us why you did that.
I wrote into the show because for a long time, I never really knew what the prolapsed uterus was, and I never knew how severe it was. And I spent a whole week with her, and I saw all the pain, the suffering, and the embarrassment she felt. And it killed me, because my mama is a very strong and independent person. And she's what inspired me to become a nurse, and she's what who encourages me to be a better person every day. That's my mama. I just don't want her to be in pain anymore.
Well, Anika and Anita, there is good news, because there are solutions to this. And of course, a more drastic problem, like it sounds like Anita has, is going to require a more drastic solution, like potentially surgery. But there is hope.
Yeah, absolutely. So in general, if you have just mild symptoms of prolapse, then you may need no treatment at all. If you have, you know, symptoms that are a little more bothersome, then sometimes pelvic physical therapy can help. Maybe your doctor will say, try not to lift heavy things. Or in some instances, you can use a removable device called a pessary. And that's just something that we put into the vagina, and it helps to hold the organs in place. But if you have really bothersome symptoms, then surgery is the answer. And of course, throughout life, you can always do Kegel exercises to help prevent it and also to help with mild symptoms.
And for anyone out there watching, if you do start to notice a bulge down in that area, the sooner you get it checked out, the more conservative you may be
Absolutely.
Able to be in your treatment. But in your case, Anita, we know this has been going on for 10 years. We're proud of you for coming here today. So Anita, we reached out to Dr. Mickey Karam, the director of gynecological surgery at the Roxbury Institute in Beverly Hills, and I have good news. He's offered to see you and treat your problem at no cost to you.
I
your godsend. Thank you.